Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 96th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Europa Clipper.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Liftoff of Falcon Heavy with Europa Clipper, unveiling the mysteries of an enormous ocean lurking beneath the icy crust of Jupiter's moon, Europa.
The side boosters which launched this mission were expended due to the extra performance needed for the mission, but both supported six missions over their lives. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 97th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1010.
Ignition and liftoff.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone shipping shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 2 has entered terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Also on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 98th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 97.
One, ignition, and liftoff Falcon 9, go to APEX, go direct to south.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 19th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This week and going into next, we can still hopefully expect to see a few Falcon launches. The first of these, the Starlink 8-19 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 17th at 7:55pm UTC or 3:55pm EDT. A few days later and we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The OneWeb 20 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 20th at 5:09am UTC or 1:09am EDT. Then a little under a day later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 661 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 20th at 11:06pm UTC or 7:06pm EDT. Jeff Faust posted some information about the Crew 9 second stage anomaly. He said SpaceX's Juliana Scheinman said the Crew 9 Falcon 9 upper stage anomaly took place when the Merlin engine ran 500 milliseconds longer than planned on its deorbit burn, causing the re-entry outside the designated zone. Heading to Boca Chica after the Super Heavy launch, SpaceX threw a party and had a cool light show on the side of Mega Bay 2. I wanted to share some more videos from the Super Heavy catch, including this view from the tower. SpaceX also posted this cool bottom-up view as Booster 12 was coming in for the landing catch. Another super cool video I wanted to share is of an onboard camera. SpaceX said onboard view showing a catch fitting on Super Heavy as it contacts a chopstick catch beam. Musk gave some information on how Booster 12 is looking after the landing catch. He said, just inspected the Starship booster which the arms have now placed back on its launch mount. Looks great. A few outer engine nozzles are warped from heating and some other minor issues, but these are easily addressed. Starship is designed to achieve reflight of its rocket booster ultimately within an hour of liftoff. The booster returns within around 5 minutes, so the remaining time is reloading propellant and placing a ship on top of the booster. There was some interesting information posted about what happened after Booster 12 was lowered back onto the launch mount. It says after the booster landed, the quick disconnect was robotically connected to it without any interference from technicians. Musk posted some information about timelines on Starship full stack reusability. He said, good chance that Starship achieves full stack reusability in 2025, which is the critical breakthrough needed to make life multiplanetary. He doubled down with this information in another post where he said, hopefully early next year we will catch the ship too. Talking about Starship performance, Musk gave some information about the new pad. He said the new launch pad is already designed for the 10,000 tons of thrust version, which is almost exactly 3 times more powerful than the Saturn V moon rocket. Here's a look at the chine that was damaged during Super Heavy's landing attempt. With an interesting first, the flight termination system was uninstalled from Booster 12. Booster 12 was lifted off of the orbital launch mount so it could be transported. It was then rolled back to the production site in order to undergo post-catch inspections. Some Booster 16 barrel sections have been spotted outside of Mega Bay 1. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.